I'm Ragini, a director at Jubilee, and have been making videos here for over a year. For those who can't tell, I'm an Indian, and in fact was born and raised in India. So to bring some shows back to my roots, I flew to New Delhi and shot a few episodes with the help of a great crew. Very excited to share the first chapter of Jubilee in India.
When I'm speaking to someone, I'll open up layer by layer.
Do you really want to commit to a lifetime of staying with someone before you've really discovered all the layers of the person?
Yeah.
Because, you know, three layers down, you might realize that you found a layer that's a deal breaker.
When I started the process of arranged marriage, I was 25. And when I got married, I was 29.
Arranged marriages is a beautiful concept because it just expands your horizon to meet more potential people.
I got arranged marriage when I was 21, and I think that was very, very young. We parted ways because we grew differently.
I do agree that arranged marriages are an entire spectrum, which also do include marriages which are autonomous, and the choice is given to the bride and groom to say no or to say yes, but by and large, I think agency is non-existent.
That setup does not kind of, you know, give you the structure or the framework to explore the other person's values and beliefs and priorities.
So I had a love marriage, but of course we grew apart. But it also gave me a lot of insight into my own self, that what did I want?
I really feel it was one of the most beautiful relationships I've ever had. Hi, I'm Reena. I'm a shoe designer, a polo player, and a DJ, and I'm pro-arranged marriage.
Hi, I'm Pankri. I'm 35 years old, and I'm a makeup artist, and I'm pro-arranged marriage.
Hi, I'm Pradyuman. I'm 31 years old. I am a jewelry designer. I'm an entrepreneur, and I was a participant in Indian matchmaking. I am pro-arranged marriage.
Hi, I am Astha. I am 22 years old. I am an aspiring musician and I'm also a law student, and I am anti-arranged marriage.
Hi, I'm Akanksha. I'm 32 years old and I work for American Express, and I'm anti-arranged marriage.
I'm Suvir. I'm 47. I'm an architect and a trainer, and I'm anti-arranged marriage.
Arranged marriages are an outdated concept. If you agree, please step forward.
We've evolved, the societies have evolved, and there's a lot about freedom and expressions, and I want to have those fulfillment. So I think in today's times, it has gone out of context.
The aspirations, regardless of the genders, are changing. How do you fit into those boxes, those pigeonholes? You cannot expect that I change my entire sense of style, my personality, the way I express myself, just because I've married you. What the hell is so special about you?
Yeah. The gender bias is it's so painfully obvious. I would never, like, voluntarily put myself in a position where some stranger can just come, evaluate my character, my market reputation, put me under labels like too dark, too thin, too fat, yes. Whatever. And actually, I was having a discussion with my best friend last night. I was telling her how excited I am to be having this conversation today. And she told me that when she was young, when she was 7 or 8, she herself was involved in these potential bride visits of her uncle. They used to go to some prospective bride's house and not even talk, just observe her. And then in the car ride back home, entire conversation would almost always center only around her physical attributes. Her belly was showing, so there were some stretch marks there. And just imagine the kind of imprint it would have had on a girl who's just 7. And she says that she still carries the insecurities that were bred because of that.
Can we have the disagreeers come forward?
Globally, arranged marriage is 60%. In India, it's still 90% with 1% divorce rate. Whereas globally, I feel right now arranged marriage is not outdated, but it's growing. That I know because I lived in New York for 10 years and my friends wanted their parents to get them arranged marriage. And these people are living, born, brought up in New York.
So,
I just feel that I think it's coming back. much more strongly. I mean, just having his show is a very big sign that in this day and age, this show has shown that even educated people are asking their parents because they believe that these values are also important. Love alone is not important.
Okay, I've been on the online dating apps as well. I'm having a great conversation with this girl. It's going wonderful, wonderful, like soulmate kind of conversation, right? One day, my data is off, I'm in some no network zone, okay? She thinks that, okay, what's happening? There's no response to it. Like, this person is not interested anymore. To continue that conversation ahead, okay, there was a drop rate of 95%. After a year, I was like, listen, I can't give so much of time trying to have this conversation with someone, and then suddenly it goes away. Yes. Arranged marriage really helps because the person is constantly obliged, okay, that speak it through. When I'm speaking to someone, I'll open up layer by layer, and that layering takes always some time. And when you have a support in terms of someone telling you and guiding you, it works wonderfully.
I have a question for you.
Just
a question to it. Do you really want to commit to a lifetime of staying with someone before you've really discovered all the layers of the person? Because, you know, three layers down, you might realize that you found a layer that's a deal breaker.
Yes, but even after a love marriage, you will find layers which are always opening up.
The mere essence, I think people have lost it over the period of time. It was a beautiful thing that two unknown people were made to meet one another through common friends and family. And if you liked each other, you continued the process. So that's the thing. It depends on how your family also portrays it to you. I was never pushed to go and meet a guy if I didn't like. So that thing, I think, and that is very liberal. I think the basic essence and the portrayal of arranged marriage should not be like, oh no, if I'm going to meet this guy, my parents are going to tell me to get marriage.
Since you use the word liberal, I just want to say that historically, a lot of arranged marriages were arranged by elders so that the caste status of the families could be maintained.
Yeah, of course, that still happens in outside Delhi. When you cross the borders of Delhi, it still happens.
Your case is more like a arranged love marriage.
It's not the pressure of getting married. It's the pressure that, you know what, the environment I'm meeting this person for in the first time is not a natural environment for me, right?
Yeah.
The guy's family is there, my family is there, I am decked up like a doll, which I am generally not. And
but you're doing it with your own wish.
I think that sense of agency and choice is very illusory, it doesn't actually exist.
I being 46, I have a lot of nieces and nephews, and I being a DJ or a polo player, I come across 25 to 35 where a lot of people want to get married. And what I see through these apps, they're breaking their hearts. They're lying.
Seriously.
It's constant lying.
Like
it's constant hooking up. It's constant this is going on. They come back. Their heart is broken. They are in depression. But what I'm saying is why arranged marriage is coming, because after your heart is broken over these apps once, twice, thrice, you confide that your parents are not going to force you, but at least do a little Reiki of that person and that family background instead of this app where people are lying. And I've also been on that app. So to be very honest, I'm the only one in my family or friends to have had arranged marriage. My experience with the arranged marriage is that it was a very exciting period. We became friends, we got to know each other, our families knew each other, the culture was similar.
So there has been a mix of arranged marriages and love marriages in my friends and my family. Most have been arranged marriages, and by God's grace, all of them have been doing very well.
Arranged marriages perpetuate religious and caste divisions.
Obviously, I talk about this whole thing with my family members a lot also. And I was talking about how autonomy is so important to me and I will only marry a person of my own choice. And they said that, kisi se bhi kar lena, bas Muslim na ho. What is that supposed to mean? I mean, why do honor killings happen? So yes, I do believe that they definitely perpetuate caste divisions, religious divisions.
So my personal experience is, my husband, he's from a Sirdar family. My father-in-law ties a turban and they go to the Gurdwara. So my thoughts were this only, that, you know, arranged marriage will have you divided into caste and, you know, have you coming from different communities and I will have different ways, religious expectations and all. But when I got married to my husband and we had an arranged marriage, till date, they have never asked me to understand or to start learning their language. If the families and everybody is liberal and open about it, you can have inter-caste marriages and they are successful.
To make my stand clear, I am pro inter-caste marriages. If you meet the right person at the right place at the right time. My only thing is that the human nature breeds on familiarity. Today I'm traveling, I see an Indian, we automatically become friends wherever we are going, right? The concept of arranged marriage is to meet the people whom you're familiar with, right? And in most cases, the familiar people are people of the same societies, of the same caste. So that is the reason I don't see it as actually perpetuating religious divide. I see it that because people are familiar, that is why there's like, you know, it's going to be easier.
Like, I'll just say that recently, I have a lot of younger friends in America, and their parents are also believing now, have changed over time and said, have introducing by arrange different castes. Like the Gujarati mother is introducing her through a known Punjabi. So things are changing in arrange too.
10 years before, I told my dad, you know, that if I like a Muslim girl, what's going to happen? Like, he's like, there's no way. Like, you know how dads are like, you know, you should know where the whole family is and this and that. Yeah. 10 years down the line, he shows me a girl who's Muslim. Like, you know what, I would really love you if you, you know, if you say yes for something like that.
Things are changing.
So things change.
I have a question for both of you. Don't you think that these personal instances that you just talked about are coming from a place of a very high level of privilege and very disconnected from how things actually happen in India?
No, India also, I'll tell you. India, I'll tell you. I mean, it's happening here, as he said, his own example. My cousins and their family also, we are Gujarati conservative family. They are showing their children now Punjabi boys. I mean, not Muslim yet, but
are
I'm
you
just
open
saying.
To considering see, that you guys are exceptions
doing.
And this is
how
not
is
the norm?
Marriage then?
No.
An arranged marriage is simply getting two known people together whom you can vouch for. So it can be of one caste or it can be of any other caste. It does not matter.
Someone I know very closely had her marriage arranged. So her parents were in a hurry to get her married. This guy was set to have a job in a bank. Now, once they actually got married, turned out that he didn't really have that bank job. He was unemployed, actually. I think when they started running out of funds, the first thing that he did was he sold off his vehicle. The next thing that he did was he sold off his wedding ring. When she told her parents, instead of taking that responsibility, they said that you should just compromise, which just made me think that that person wasn't to find the right partnership, but it was to reduce that financial liability on the family.
Parental support is pivotal for a successful marriage.
From my personal experience, when I got married, I had a lot of adjustment issues with my in-laws. My husband could not understand my agony. So there I had to go and call my mom and ask for a lot of advices. Even when I had a fallout with my husband and, you know, there were certain problems, my mother always told me that, you know, I have your back, you can come back to me anytime. And she always told me that we are there with you no matter what, and which I think that all parents are always there, and I feel it's very important.
I actually agree to what you're saying. Me and my husband, we met through a friend, and ours is a love marriage. And for us, when our families met, they didn't really like each other so much. But his family never had a problem with me, and my family never had a problem with him. And they've been rock solid support for me and my husband. My father-in-law has always, you know, built me up. I mean, if me and my husband fight, and my father-in-law finds out about it, he's probably going to side with me. And my father, he sees my husband like a second son, and it makes life so much easier.
In my opinion, it's always a good point to, you know, at least have your family as the team to make a decision. They're always going to wish well for you. You sit down and explain that I really love her. I really want to be with her. And, you know, I will see myself happy with her. And I'm sure there are people, maybe the first time they disagree, but over the time, if they see that you're persistent, it works.
Yeah. My parents have been my best friends since age of 5, you know. There's nothing that I don't talk to her, even today. You know what I mean? If any problem would happen, I would call her up and say, Mom, now this happened. Or Mom, what do I do with this?
I'm not denying what they're saying, But parental support is always there. Why are you narrowing down your parents when it comes to your relationship? I want to love somebody because I love that person. I want to raise my own family. Unless my parents have raised me wrong, why will I make a decision? No, you let me complete, please. Sorry, you not let me complete. So unless I have been raised in a wrong way, why will I choose somebody or be with somebody who will not have the same values as me? I'm going to be with my partner for a longer time than I have been with my parents since I met my partner. So I want to take care of them for 60 more years. So I'm thinking there, I'm not thinking now.
Don't you get a little insensitive towards your parents? Maybe they also want to be a part when you're choosing your partner. Maybe
I'm not
they
denying
have,
that.
Suppose you have a rift with your spouse.
Yep.
And you are confused. And you ask your parents. Would you ask your parents for their opinion?
What their
Why are
problem?
We placing parental judgment yes. on such a pedestal?
No, absolutely.
And, hang on one second. Just one more thing.
One second.
Also, if there is a rift between me and my spouse, that's an amazing opportunity for me to understand each other and grow. My parents did have an arranged marriage, and I didn't see any issues. We were brought up very nicely. There was no problems in that setup. But today, people are looking for more freedom, for more personal growth.
Marriage is primarily about love.
A true love means when you accept your partner with all his flaws and how you tend to go on in life keeping those things together, because after a particular time in life it's difficult for people to change. So I think love is an overall picture. You cannot say that no, I want a perfect partner or I wanted a perfect wife.
Yes.
No, I think what makes perfect is like your imperfections, someone
That's
who
true.
Accepts you, and that is what I believe is true love.
Your children will probably get married and leave, your friends will have their own lives and get on with them, but the one person that you decide to live your entire life with, I don't think a marriage should be for one and one thing alone, but I do think that love should definitely be one of those things.
Because of an arranged marriage, and I really felt that when I got married, it was not about love. I mean, you can't just love somebody when you just meet them once or twice. And that's why I feel it's not primarily about love, it's about being friends, about knowing each other and growing to each other. And I feel in arranged marriage, love grows eventually. So that's what I feel.
So I would slightly deviate from you there, because so you said that arranged marriages are about growing together and growing into love eventually.
Yeah.
But I think arranged marriages are a huge gamble, a much bigger gamble than what a non-arranged marriage might be. Because I have friends whose parents have had arranged marriages, but there is no love in those marriages. Seeing that, I just think that when the stake is so big, not just your own life, but your children, I think it's a slightly bigger gamble than I myself would be ready to take.
I've met quite a few people during the last couple of years. And when you ask a girl, right, that what are you looking in marriage for? First thing is like trust. Trust is the prima thing always, that trust. And then obviously there's love, which builds in. Is built from trust,
okay.
And that gets directly reflected
I'm
on that
I'm going
part.
To cut you there and tell you about a small anecdote, okay? My husband and I, we met through a mutual friend and we fell in love and we got married. But before that happened, my parents introduced me to multiple prospects and I trusted their assessment of this prospect, and I said, fine, if you think he's the right match for me, I will go ahead and get engaged to this person. Twice. My engagement was called off for silly reasons. One guy refused to even tell me a reason why. He sends me a text at the end of the month saying, the month is over and so are we. And then when we sat down as families to talk about it, he got physical with my father. Is that fair? And is that my father's fault? Or can I say that I refuse to trust my father because this has happened? So this is one. This was the second guy, actually. The first one. My parents found his matrimonial ad in a newspaper. I think 2 days before the engagement, we get a call from the elder brother's wife, and she tells us that she's filed multiple cases of dowry demands and domestic violence against the entire family. How do my parents find this out?
But I mean,
we were fortunate that we found this out.
But then that's because you went through a newspaper. It was not like a common
arranged marriage.
It's
exactly.
Not,
the idea is to get more concrete people
like,
before.
Usually, arranged marriages happen when you know the other family.
But this happens. When I came to the age of getting married, the first attempt was actually going through the path of arranged marriages, and those experiences were not nice at all. The one arranged marriage that I've seen the most closely is the one of my parents, and it's not been the smoothest of the marriages.
What I came across this process was that people are very judgmental. They objectify you as a commodity. So I was body shamed. I was rejected. But eventually I did get married. It was an arranged marriage, and my husband accepted me for what I am, who I am, irrespective of my weight, my caste, or my financial background.
I have always wanted a big fat Indian wedding.
At 20, I didn't know better. I wasn't very exposed. So of course I wanted, and I did have. I had like a whole week of whatever I wanted, you know? I mean, it was, and I, because my thought was that I marry once and I want to do it all. Of course, now my thoughts are completely different, and I feel what a waste of money that was.
Having a big fat wedding, having all our relatives around, having all the festivities, having all the Bollywood tamasha.
Yeah, exactly.
I always wanted to be the heroine because that was my time to shine. So, but I did keep it in mind, you know, that we don't overspend.
Sure.
And I realized also over the period of time that, you know, we as girls are more fascinated by the idea of the wedding rather than marriage.
I agree.
So I can never relate to a big fat wedding because for me, I've seen how we as Indians have grown. Earlier, there were small festivals, used to be all about togetherness, celebrating together. That essence is gone. In fact, I don't get to meet my relatives for years. Why should they drop in for my marriage? I don't understand that. Because I don't understand that. Instead, some of my friends and from other family people and common people have become so close to me, and we have some common interests and we have a great evening. So why should they not be involved?
I don't like big fat Indian weddings because they're breeding grounds for further arranged marriages.
That's
like
a good one.
All aunties casually scanning you and subtly and not subtly making remarks. I think I would rather just lay back and stay away from all that.
I would get a divorce if I'm unhappy in my marriage.
Why would you take
that? Oh. Wow.
I am divorced, so I'm a living example of that if I'm not happy, I will, because I really believe that two people can grow apart, grow differently. And then you definitely make a choice to be happy and cut the cord when it needs to be cut.
So I've been married for 5.5 years now, and first 3 years of my married life were very tough. And I did reach a point where both of us decided to get divorced. We lived 6 months separately, but things turned around and we realized that, no, you know, we should give it another shot. And coming from there, we realized what is that is going to give us happiness, what will make our relationship better. So yes, I did get into a situation, but I did not get divorced. We, I would say, crossed that bridge, and today I am in a much happier marriage.
I think life is about priorities, right? And if there comes a point where giving up on one of your priorities literally drains the joy out of your life, then you cannot make the other person happy. Unfortunately, my parents don't have the smoothest of the marriages. And it's been difficult as their child, because I can see that my father is unhappy and my mother is unhappy. And it's not because either of them are bad people. It's just because they've grown in different directions. And maybe if they had separated, they would have been happier.
Yeah. True.
I would like to comment on that also, because I lost my mother 2 months back. Unfortunately, when my parents had a very different marriage life, and I do believe that had my mother taken the step of divorcing and found her happiness and found herself, she would have been much more happier and maybe around us right now. I believe very strongly that if
Two unhappy people cannot make a happy life together.
Absolutely.
And to be happy with yourself, you can only give happiness to others if you are at peace with yourself, if you are happy from inside.
I think that arranged or not arranged, right? We all agreed at one point that it is very important to be happy.
That's true.
And I think that's the underlying fact,
that's
either
true.
Which way is in any relationship, whichever way you find it, whichever way you have to make it work, just be happy. And I think that I was so glad that that time no one said that, okay, happiness is something you can discount.
It was nice seeing you.
Bye. It was so nice to meet you all.
Yes.
Likewise.
And let's.